This video was made in collaboration with the Avatar Wiki. If you'd like to learn more, check out the link in the description. The History of the Southern Water Tribe. The Southern Water Tribe is an independent state located at the South Pole and is the southern division of the Water Tribes. A federation of several smaller tribes, the South is ruled by a council of elders who also elect the tribe's chief. The Southern Water Tribe has had an eventful history and saw times of prosperity and freedom, as well as decline and genocide. Welcome to the Imagi. In today's video, we're going over the history of the Southern Water Tribe. Before we begin, we publish new content every week, so be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. Foundation and growth. Originally, the Water Tribe existed as one nation, solely based in the North Pole. However, following civil unrest, a large group of warriors, waterbenders, and healers journeyed to the South Pole to engender a new tribal confederation of several autonomous chiefdoms. The Southern tribesmen eventually agreed to re-accept the Northern chief as their ruler, as long as they were granted autonomy and their own government for internal affairs. As such, the chiefdoms of the South were governed by a supreme council of elders that in turn answered to the chief of the Water Tribes. Otherwise, the minor chiefdoms worked with each other on equal terms and had far-reaching autonomy, including making their own laws. Over time, Southerners married into the ruling family of the North, strengthening the tribal ties. Despite this political rapprochement, the enormous geographical distance between the two sects caused them to evolve differently. Even though their cultures were still similar, as they maintained common customs and celebrations until 40 AG, the people of the North and South developed completely differently in regard to society and politics. The Southern Water Tribe was far less hierarchical than the North, enjoying a high degree of gender equality. The Southern tribesmen eventually built a massive inland city as their political and cultural center, and the tribe began to prosper, even though it never reached the size and importance of the North. Some tensions remained between the sister tribes, as some Northerners regarded the Southerners as barbarians, whereas some among the latter believed the North to be an oppressive society. During these years, a tradition of celebrating the Glacier Spirits Festival began, during which the people would fast and meditate, and the tribal elders would commune with the spirits as they danced in the sky to create the Southern Lights. It ended on the day of the winter solstice. The Southern tribesmen also began to travel around the world. One group of Southern waterbenders discovered the foggy swamp in the Earth Kingdom thousands of years before the Hundred Year War. They decided to stay because of the abundant amounts of water there, engendering the Foggy Swamp Tribe in the process. However, as the Foggy Swamp tribesmen maintained isolation, the people of the South Pole never learned of these events. Economic stagnancy in the Age of Pirates. Though the Southern Water Tribe remained relatively stable, it was unable to prosper to the same degree as its sister tribe. By the late 4th and early 3rd century BG, the South was comparatively weak in economic and political terms, and regarded by outsiders as impoverished and technologically outpaced. At the time, it claimed the uninhabited Chuji Islands as its own, but was too weak to force the Earth Kingdom to give up the islands. The South's weakness contributed to many Southerners taking up piracy as a profession to achieve the wealth and power they could not gain through legitimate means. As the South lacked a professional navy due to a lack of native woods to build warships, pirates quickly became widespread around the South Pole, further isolating the Southern Water Tribe economically. One family of Southern descent in particular became infamous as leaders of the Fifth Nation, an ethnically mixed people of corsairs that roamed the seas for generations. The Southern Water Tribe eventually disowned the entire family tree of Tagaka, head of the Fifth Nation at the time. Regardless, Tagaka portrayed herself as the protector of the Southern Water Tribe and even attempted to get appointed as guardian of the South Pole. In 296 BG, the Fifth Nation was defeated by a force led by Yun, an Earth Kingdom man presumed to be the Avatar. Afterwards, the Earth Kingdom's leading politician, Jianju, requested his government to grant the South a loan to develop its own deep water navy to protect itself as well as trade in its waters, thereby ensuring future progress and prosperity. Jianju's efforts came to naught due to the machinations of his political rival, Chamberlain Hui, and the Earth Kingdom government refused to grant any loans. As a result, the Southern Water Tribe remained politically and militarily weak. Raids. With the outbreak of the Hundred Year War in 0 AG, the Southern Water Tribe took up arms against the Fire Nation, though the tribe itself remained rather unscathed until around 40 AG. By then, Fire Lord Azalon began to perceive the South as a threat for his expansion and ordered his navy to annihilate the tribe's military strength. Consequently, The Fire Navy employed raiding forces of firebenders and cruisers in order to capture or kill as many Southern waterbenders as they could. By doing so, the Fire Nation hoped to destroy all resistance in the South. Despite being outnumbered, the waterbenders and non-bending warriors were able to defend themselves against the raids through fierce resistance, boasting minor victories such as successfully trapping a Fire Nation ship, which eventually developed into the shipwreck. However, their determination was not enough, and a systematic set of attacks eventually left Hama as the only waterbender left, prior to her eventual surrender. Following the widespread destruction and loss of life that the raids had caused, tribal unity declined and the capital city was largely abandoned. The small chiefdoms and tribes that formed the Southern Confederation divided and scattered throughout the South Pole, and all contact to the Northern Water Tribe was lost. Many Southerners would blame the North for effectively abandoning them to the Fire Nation, and eventually sought to aid the Earth Kingdom in their deepest crisis. Even though the South was virtually defeated, the raids continued by the Southern Raiders, who attacked the minor tribe of Chieftain Hakoda in 94 AG. They had been informed that one waterbender remained in the Southern Water Tribe, and were subsequently assigned to eliminate that person. Knowing that the remaining waterbender was her 8-year-old daughter Katara, Kaya gave her life by confessing to Captain Yon Ra that she was the person they were after. Her death provided the Fire Nation with the impression that the Southern waterbending lineage had been completely eradicated, which left Katara as the sole known survivor. At least two other waterbending children, Siku and Sura, survived in hiding in a remote village deep in the South Pole's interior. In the final years of the Hundred Year War, the Southern Water Tribe was in dire straits and teetering on the brink of extinction. As its population struggled to survive, many old traditions to appease the spirits were forgotten or abandoned, rendering the land spiritually unbalanced as well. As a result, angry spirits turned dark and formed the Everstorm. Many remaining male warriors left their chiefdoms for the Earth Kingdom to aid them against the Fire Nation, leaving the population of the tribe to consist mostly of elderly, middle-aged women, mothers, and very young children. In 99 AG, Katara and Sokka discovered Avatar Aang, which resulted in Fire Prince Zuko raiding their village and capturing Aang. Sokka and Katara subsequently left the village as well in an attempt to save the Avatar, and began to travel together with him to end the war. After the Siege of the North, a group of waterbenders and healers from the Northern Water Tribe were sent to the South to help rebuild it, one of whom was the waterbending master Paku. This mission became known as the Southern Reconstruction Project. The Southern Reconstruction Project. Even though the initial Northern Relief Expedition aided the Southern Water Tribe in the slow process of rebuilding, the living conditions and economic situation of the South remained dire, forcing several Southerners to seek work abroad. The end of the Hundred Year War made the Southern Reconstruction Project easier, and the situation of the Southern Water Tribe started to improve greatly by 102 AG. Political unity was restored, and Hakoda, originally a local chief, was elected head chieftain of the entire South. Under his guidance and with the aid of the Northerners Malik and Malina, a new city was erected in the place of Hakoda's old village. Factories as well as docks were built, and new technologies were introduced to improve the living conditions in the South and help it become an equal partner in world politics. One company that aided the Southern Reconstruction Project was the Earth and Fire Industries. The growing influence of the North did not meet universal approval, however, as many Southerners feared that their sister tribe was actually planning to subjugate the South and wipe out its unique culture. An extremist faction led by the Hundred Year War veteran Gilak consequently prepared for a rebellion to overthrow Hakoda and drive out all Northerners as well as foreign influences. When a gigantic amount of crude oil was discovered beneath the South Pole, however, the Northern Water Tribe decided that the Southerners were not ready to handle such a resource. Secret plans were drafted which would effectively make the South a colony of the Northern Water Tribe. Malina later decided that they should abandon this approach, but unbeknownst to her, Malik continued to prepare for the colonization of the South Pole. Gilak's followers managed to steal Malik's documents in 102 AG and revealed his plans to the public at a festival celebrating the Southern Reconstruction Project's success. Though Gilak failed to kill Malik and Malina and was captured along with most of his militants, his message spread among the South's population. Resentment grew about the Northern Water Tribe, and elements of Hakoda's security forces subsequently helped the extremists to break out of prison. As Hakoda held a conference with Fire Lord Zuko and Earth King Kuei to discuss international collaboration in developing the South, Gilak and his nationalist rebels entered and began attacking. Successfully managing to kidnap the Earth King, Gilak sent a messenger hawk to the town hall, offering to exchange the king for Chief Hakoda. During the exchange at the Bridge of No Return, Team Avatar deceived Thod and his chi blockers by wearing protective chainmail, Dolgellok refused to surrender and cut the suspension rope in an attempt to kill Quay and Hakoda. Team Avatar ultimately managed to rescue the two heads of state, though Dolgellok fell to his death in the ravine, putting an end to the nationalist revolt. Resurgence under Northern rule. Over time, the North restored its rule over the Southern Water Tribe and sent many more waterbenders and resources to aid its sister tribe. Eventually, the South grew prosperous again, prompting the North to demand taxes in return for their help. With the South's economic and social resurgence, the old Council of Elders was restored and resumed their rule over the South Pole, maintaining the tribe's autonomy under jurisdiction of the Northern Chief. Following the creation of the United Republic, the South was given a seat on the United Republic Council, charging one of its residents with helping to oversee the sovereign state. Many of the Southern tribe's citizens also emigrated to the United Republic over the years, where a cultural center was built for them in the capital itself. In 153 AG, the next avatar in the cycle, Korra, was born in the Southern Water Tribe. A large compound was built for her to train under the Order of the White Lotus in waterbending, earthbending, and firebending. By this time, the tribe's villages had grown into cities and formerly uninhabited tundra became colonized. With its growing economic power, the Southern tribesmen became more independent and discontent with the North's rule and its taxes. Support for independence became widespread, and the Northern chief was seen as little more than a figurehead, as opposed to the Council of Elders and the local chieftains, who were more readily accepted as rightful rulers of the Southern Water Tribe. In 170 AG, Avatar Korra left the compound in the Southern Water Tribe to help the world. By early 171 AG, dark spirits began to attack tribesmen at the South Pole and ships in the Southern Tribe's waters. Consequently, Unalaq, chief of the water tribes at the time, traveled to the south in order to restore local spirituality and end the attacks. Taking Korra as his spiritual disciple, the chief traveled with her to the center of the South Pole in order for her to open the spirit portal and allow the spirit lights to return, thus lighting up the southern sky with dancing spirits once more. Civil War. After the spirit portal was opened, Chief Unalaq summoned his forces to the tribe in an abrasive attempt to unite the North and South. Most Southerners felt that the Northern military presence was threatening their autonomy, and unrest soon ensued, resulting in talks of a rebellion. Avatar Korra attempted to defuse the tension by reminding her people that they were all part of the same tribe, though her mediation was seen by the Southerners as her siding with the Northern regime. Eventually, a group of rebels, supported by Varric Global Industries, made an attempt to kidnap Unalaq, though Korra thwarted the plot as it was being carried out. The chief commanded that the rebels be thrown in prison forever, but Korra successfully convinced him to allow them to stand trial, as she thought it would appease the South. However, Unalaq suspected Korra's parents, Tanrak and Senna, of being part of the attempted assassination and ordered them arrested. The accused were brought before Judge Hota, who acquitted Senna but sentenced the others to life imprisonment. Korra later confronted Hota and learned that the entire trial was a sham orchestrated by Unalaq. Thus, she and her friends busted her father and the rebels out of prison, officially igniting a civil war between the water tribes. Now led by Tanrak, the rebels subsequently retreated to the hills outside of Harbor City. Unalaq decided not to confront them, however, opting to increase the protection of the spirit portal as it was vital to his plans. With harmonic convergence nearing, Tanrak went on the offensive, though his forces were completely defeated by the northern troops, who received help from the dark spirits. Despite this defeat, Avatar Korra defeated Una-Vatu, the merger between Unalaq and Vatu. Soon after, she declared the Water Tribe's civil war to be over and announced the Southern Water Tribe's independence with the reinstated Council of Elders having elected Tanrak as the new chief. Independence. Just a week after gaining its independence, the South was infiltrated by Hunan's dark spirits and Equalus. They occupied large parts of the South Pole's hinterland and the local spirit portal, though were eventually driven out by Avatar Korra. Months later, Korra spent 2 years at the Southern Water Tribe, recovering physically from her mercury poisoning suffered at the hands of the Red Lotus, until her departure to the Earth Kingdom in 173 AG. Government. Originally, the individual villages and sub-tribes of the Southern Water Tribe were each led by a single leader or chief. Hakoda led the southernmost tribe in 100 AG, for instance. During this time, the Southern Water Tribe was a much smaller and less stratified society, unlike its northern counterpart. The chiefs treated each other as equals, and the smaller tribes had great autonomy over their jurisdiction. Following the Hundred Year War, Hakoda was elected head chieftain of the Southern Water Tribe, making him the South's head of state. Years later, the Southern Water Tribe accepted the authority of the Northern Water Tribe chiefdom, but retained autonomy. a council of chieftains and elders officially govern the Southern Water Tribe, consisting of male and female representatives of the different cities, villages, tribes, and social classes within the settlements. The council assembles in the Southern Water Tribe Royal Palace, which serves as the formal seat of government in the South Pole. Traditionally residing in the north, the tribal chief does not hold much more than a figurehead position to the Southerners. His primary duties involve ceremonial and representative tasks. In times of crisis, nevertheless, the chief of the Northern Water Tribe can take a much stronger hold on the Southern Water Tribe's functions. Northern intervention, however, is not well received in the South, as was evident when a blight involving dark spirits prompted Chief Unalaq to intervene in the Southern Water Tribe's affairs. Many tribesmen saw Unalaq and his forces as oppressors, demonstrating the strong spirit of independence in the South. Citizens of the Southern Water Tribe who commit a crime have the right to a trial prior to being incarcerated. The following tribunals are held in a courtroom located inside the Royal Palace, where a single jurist oversees the court proceedings. After the Water Tribe Civil War, Avatar Korra declared the war over and the Southern Water Tribe an independent state. The chieftains elected the Avatar's father, Tanrak, to be their next chief. Culture, ice dodging. The tribe has a unique rite of passage called ice dodging, a coming-of-age ritual that serves as a young boy's first step towards being realized as a true warrior. When a boy reaches the age of 14, his father takes him out to sea and challenges him to guide the boat through iceberg-studded waters. The father watches but doesn't interfere. If the boy succeeds, his father places a ceremonial mark on his forehead, symbolizing the virtue he demonstrated most prominently during the test. The mark of the wise is awarded to those who show leadership and decisiveness. The mark of the brave is given for inspirational displays of courage, and the mark of the trusted is bestowed upon those who prove themselves to be exceptionally steady and dependable. The Southern Water Tribe is willing to adapt traditions such as ice dodging when circumstances warrant it. When Bato realized that Sokka had never undergone the ritual due to Hakoda's departure, he took Sokka, Katara, and Aang on an ice dodging expedition in rocky Earth Kingdom waters. When they succeeded, he marked all three and declared Aang an honorary member of the Water Tribe. Culture, gender equality. While the Northern Water Tribe is an exceptionally strict patriarchal culture, gender roles in the Southern Water Tribe are far less rigid. Katara was shocked to learn that the Northern Tribe forbade women from learning waterbending apart for healing purposes, seeing how her father Hakoda recognized her bending abilities early on and unsuccessfully sought a master to teach her. Female waterbenders actively participate in battle, and female non-benders such as Lirin also serve in combat roles such as officers and guards. Furthermore, women are never forced into arranged marriages, but are instead free to marry whomever they see fit. Nevertheless, the Southern Tribe doesn't seem to be entirely free of gender roles. Until his encounter with the Kyoshi warriors, Sokka displayed a sexist attitude, claiming on numerous occasions that men are naturally better than women at tasks like hunting, fishing, and non-bending combat. During the siblings' childhood, Katara was responsible for women's work like washing and mending clothes, including Sokka's. In contrast, he was allowed to spend his time training younger boys to defend the village against the Fire Nation, despite the fact that his preparations were inadequate to deal with any real attack. However, even Sokka was notably shocked and confused to learn of the Northern Water Tribe's patriarchal customs. In general, the Southern Water Tribe seems to have a simpler, less hierarchical culture and a more open-minded and flexible mindset. Culture, games. Children of the tribe play a game called penguin sledding, which consists of catching an otter penguin and riding its back as a makeshift sled. One typically lures in the otter penguin with a fish to make catching it easier. Buildings. In 99 AG, most of the residents in Sokka and Katara's village slept in tents made of sealskin. However, prior to the destruction inflicted during the Fire Nation attacks, residents of the Southern Water Tribe lived in igloo-like structures. The inside of a typical Southern Water Tribe hut contained a number of animal pelts that were placed on bamboo floors. At one end of the hut, a sealskin tent would be set up for use as a sleeping chamber. Ceremonial animal headdresses, spears, and animal skins were usually displayed on the walls of the hut. In the center of the hut would be a square fire pit surrounded by a single line of bricks. The fire provided heat for the hut and was also used to prepare food. There were mats for sitting on all four sides of the fire pit. A stew post used for cooking would hang suspended from the ceiling, hovering above the fire. Warriors. Warriors of the Southern Water Tribe wield weapons that include clubs, scimitars, bone spears used in spear fishing, bladed boomerangs, machetes with whale teeth on the dull side of the blade, and highly resistant shields. Black and white war paint in a pattern reminiscent of a wolf is traditionally applied to the face before entering a battle. During the invasion of the Fire Nation, all the warriors wore wolf-headed helmets and suits of armor. It seems as though all adult men of the tribe are expected to be fully trained warriors. 2 years prior to Avatar Aang's reawakening, all the tribe's men sailed to the Earth Kingdom to join the war effort. It is unclear whether women without bending abilities are ever allowed to train as warriors, but there are very few women left behind, so the lack of women in the war party may simply reflect the tribe's overall population decline as a result of the Fire Nation attacks. It is clear that women who are waterbenders are accepted as fighters in the Southern Water Tribe. A flashback shows Hama and other women using their waterbending abilities to defend the tribe against the Fire Nation raid, and the Northern faction's custom of restricting female waterbenders from combat takes Katara completely by surprise. Although the tribe had grown significantly in size after the end of the Hundred Year War, by 171 AG it still lacked manpower and organization when compared to the Northern forces. Natural resources and foods. Inhabiting frozen poles near the seas, the water tribes inherently are dependent on the oceans and the frozen tundra for a majority of their natural resources. The South Pole harbors the greatest known deposit of crude oil in the world. Skins from seals are used to create tents, while pelts from polar bears and other furry animals are used for clothing and for covering for barren surfaces. Naturally, hunters and fishermen of the water tribes are some of the best in the world in their field. Sea prunes are a particular favorite fruit and ingredient. Squid and seaweed can be used to make a wide variety of dishes, including soup, seasoning, and even bread and cookies. The Southern Water Tribe has its own cuisine, which is similar to that of the Northern Water Tribe, but still has many unique elements. It's dominated by meat. Following the foundation of the United Republic, the Southern cuisine spread there as well. For instance, a renowned restaurant, Narok Seaweed Noodlery, offered authentic Southern Water Tribe cuisine in Republic City by 170 AG. Did you enjoy our video? Be sure to check out these other great videos from the Imagi, and make sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.